Hi, my name is Mike from the Maine Permitted Skills School. First weekend in September every year is the time for our Maine Primitive Gathering. Incredible talent from all around the country comes to practice their skills in bow drill, hand drill, fiber arts, bows, arrows, atlatl. Hey, all of the primitive skills you can conceive of, from brain tan buckskin through stalking and hunting games to wild edibles and medicinals. We invite you to come to this amazing event. In fact, I'm on my way now, except, oh man. I almost left underdressed.
Well, come on.
Primitive skills aren't so primitive when you start studying them. They're very scientific. There's a lot of skill that goes into primitive skills. And especially in our region, the temperate region, you need community. Even just brain tanning a deer hide, it takes hours and hours, and calories to do it. And while you're doing that, you still need to cut firewood, gather autumn olives, make shoe leather, gather the acorns. That's why people had large families and lived in tribes.
You can try to do primitive skills by yourself, and you can get pretty far. But you get to a certain point and you realize that you need community. Whether you're trying to be independent or not, it's all about interdependence. And you can take your level of skill and knowledge of primitive skills so much further if you look to your community to help you grow, to help you feel vibrant and alive.
As you can tell from my hands, I've been playing with the fire saw. And I struggled with it, and then I spoke with a gentleman who's passion is like the fire saw is like his favorite thing to do, and he showed me just a few simple tricks that just blew my mind. So, you know, there's community, and you know, bringing in growth for, you know, and now we're sharing it. There's been so many of us that have been playing around with it. Now fire has been shared with many people here, and it's pretty awesome.
A lot about intention, and I've been thinking a lot about my intentions for my life and really weaving my prayers into this, and I feel like when we come together as a community and weave our intentions and our goals and our visions, that it makes it that much stronger.
1, 2, 3.
In my experience, when you're doing primitive skills, you've got like so many different people who have all been trying them for so long. And when you put that many people together, you get such an amazing amount of knowledge. The amount of knowledge you can get from this weekend is more than I could ever get like in a school year.
You don't want to carry that back now.
Just sharing skills brings people together.
Yeah.
And having a community in place facilitates the passing on of those skills. And all those ways of connection in a really powerful way, more so than doing it on your own would or could ever. Not that doing it on your own is a bad thing, but
right.
Having a community in place
passes
that on effortlessly. That kind of goes both ways. It helps learn them, and the primitive skills help facilitate a community. Just admit anyone not interested in this stuff. I can get anyone to come experience a friction fire or a skinning demo or something of the likes and get them into that, and it brings community.
When I work with students, you know, the survival, primitive skills that they're excited about are fire, and you know, they want to learn how to make a bow drill set, and they want to learn how to, you know, flint knap, and they want to learn how to hunt things and make traps. But what they don't realize is that working in community is going to be the most essential survival skill that they could possibly have. And I don't ever have to say it out loud, because with all of these primitive skills, when you're working on them, you realize that humans are communal creatures, and these skills don't come alone. Like, you need people next to you. Teachers, elders, other people that you're teaching, partners, you just can't do it alone. So I don't think those two things are, you can't take them apart. They're completely together. And if you ask me what's the most important survival skill, I'd say being in community.
Builds up some really good hand muscles.